everyone, it's Veronica here. Welcome to this tutorial. We're gonna be talking about HD lipstick makeup, specifically for Lelutka Evolution heads, because those are my favorite heads I'm working with. And I was approached by many people saying they struggle with creating makeup, or they just started and don't know how to do it. So I decided it's gonna be way more easier just to show you. In this tutorial, I'm not gonna teach you how to draw your lipstick. It would take so much more time than that. I'm gonna teach you how to use photo resources, and it will be very easy. I already downloaded image of this beautiful lipstick. I downloaded it from freepic.com. It's a website with images for your business. I think it was $10 per month, which is awesome deal, because you're gonna get 100 downloads per day, not per month, per day. And if you're gonna create makeup, this site is for you, because there's tons of artists doing just makeup shots. So I strongly recommend visiting this website. First thing first, I'm not a professional. I'm a hobbyist, like most creators in SLR. Everything I'm gonna be showing you in this video is everything I taught myself. It works for me, and maybe it will work for someone else. So let's get started. We're just gonna crop our lipstick. Control C. Hide this layer, and show HD lips. We're gonna set transparency to 50, and we're gonna stretch our layer to the size of the template underneath. All right, I think this is as close as we can get. Now we're gonna go to filter, liquify. And we're gonna fix the shape a little bit. Let's center this, stretch this side. Let's alter the Cupid's bow a little bit so it's not that pointy. Okay, let's shrink the layer a little bit. And you can see the shape is a little bit off, so we're gonna go back to filter, liquify, and move the Cupid's bow to the left side a little bit more. Let's shrink this layer a little bit, and that looks about right. Let's go back to our layer, just hide the lipstick. You can see this black part, sorry, undo move. This black part, this dark part, is the middle of your lips. So we're gonna shape the lipstick according to this layer. So let's go back to liquify. And we need to stretch the middle part a little bit more to shape our lipstick the same way the layer underneath is. Let's move the shine a little bit down. You can always see the layer underneath when you move this slider. I just like to use it this way, because you can see the changes in real time. If you do it with the layer underneath, you always see the previous shape of your layers. So I don't want to see that. That's why my slider is all the way to the left side. It's always according to your preferences. So if you like to see the previous shape so you can see the changes you made, just move the slider to the 50, for example. Okay, I think this shape could actually work. Let's go back. All right. Hit left control on your keyboard, click left mouse button on the HD ellipse, and you can see the shape we did here. You can see the shape of the layer underneath. So we're gonna stretch our lipstick a little bit more. Let's hit the transparent to the 50 again so we can see the layer underneath. Let's go back to filter and liquify. And now we want to see the layer underneath so we can fix the edges exactly according to our layer. Okay, now hold control on your keyboard, left click HD ellipse, and the shape is what we need right now. Okay, so we're just gonna play with the corners a little bit more, so go filter, liquify. And just move the corners a little bit. And that should do the trick. Control left click HD ellipse. And yeah, I think we can go with this shape. However, we're gonna move the right side a little bit so there is no skin showing. So we're going back to filter, liquify, and it was the right side. So we're gonna move it a little bit. And again, left control, left click HD ellipse, and the shape is what we need. Yeah, we can go with this. Okay, so hide this layer, duplicate HD ellipse, and what I like to do is go to filter, blur, and blur the template a little bit so we have soft edges. Okay. Left control, left click, show the lipstick layer. Control C, Control Shift and V. The reason I use Ctrl Shift and V is because it will place your layer exactly where the previous layer was. So if we went with Ctrl V, the layer would be shifted. So that's why Ctrl Shift and Ctrl V. Now we're gonna hide the lipstick layer and we're left with this. Next thing I'm gonna do is we need to fill this middle part so there are no teeth. Go to layer, new layer, and choose a soft brush. Hit Alt on your keyboard and pick a color of this middle part. We're gonna go with darker and we will fill this middle part with our new color. Don't be afraid to go a little bit onto the edges of your lips. We're gonna smooth it out anyway. Go to filter, blur, and blur this layer a little bit. I think we're gonna go to image, adjustment, hue and saturation, and change the color a little bit, make it darker. Okay, I think it could actually work. Let's just erase a little bit from the edge. Okay, we need the soft brush for that. All right, let's go 50 and erase from the edge a little bit. I think we can go a little bit more darker, so adjustment, hue and saturation. And let's go a little bit darker. Okay, and our teeth are hidden. Let's hide our HD lips template, and we're left with this. Now we're gonna match our middle part with the lipstick. And we're gonna go to layer, new, and we will fill this layer with white color. Reason for that is if you drag this layer underneath your lipstick, you're gonna see if you made any mistakes. And I think it looks kind of fine. You can of course play with more shading, with highlights, you can shape it differently. This is just a very quick tutorial to show you how to do it. So if we took more time, the lipstick would look way better, of course. This is just for demonstration, so you know exactly what I'm talking about. Let's hide this layer. I think we're gonna reduce the saturation, so yeah. And I'm gonna show you how to tint your layer, which is also important. Many people would do adjustment, hue and saturation, and just change the color. But that will affect even the highlights of your lipstick, and we don't want that, and we don't want to destroy our layer. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create new layer. Fill this layer, for example, with pink color. We're gonna go with this color. Let's fill this, and we're gonna do a clipping mask. Hold left alt and hover between your layers. You're gonna see this little arrow, click it, and there is a clipping mask. Which means if you're gonna go to brush and you're gonna draw over this layer, it won't go over the edge. I'm gonna show you. Let's go with black color. It doesn't go over the edges. Everything will stay on this layer. So we're gonna set the layer to color, hue, saturation, whichever you like. I'm gonna go with color. I will reduce it to 50. Let's go 50. The next thing we can do is smooth out the lipstick a little bit more. So we're gonna go to filter, sharpen. I know it doesn't sound very logical, but believe me, it's under sharpen. I like this function. Go to smart sharpen and hit reduce noise to 100, and it will smooth out the lip texture a little bit. You can also play with radius and you will get this effect, which I really don't want. I just wanna smooth out the layer a little bit. Okay, I think we can do some testing. So let's export this layer. Export as. We're gonna save it as PNG. The classic size of this template is 248. We don't want that. We want to reduce the size of our lipstick, so we're gonna go with 50% and choose resample, preserve details. I did extensive trying, let's say, when I was uploading my last skin, and I tried every type of resample, and I figured the preserve details looks the best. So we're gonna go with that. You can also choose nearest neighbor, which will enhance this texture of your lipstick. Whichever you like, you have to do some testing and trying to see what matches your preferences. I'm just gonna go with preserve details and export all, save it to the desktop, and we're gonna go to do some testing in world. I already prepared this tiny hat. It's just two wrist rims. We need to link them together, so we're gonna select the first frame, which will be our button. Select shift on your keyboard and click the base of your hat. Now link those objects together, and you can see our base is yellow, which means it's a root frame, and that's exactly what we need. Now we're gonna drag applier scripts from Lelutka developer's kit into our root frame. Always make sure the scripts are set to copy and not anything else. Also, your prims should be copy and no modify. I'm wearing currently Lelutka Evolution Head Extreme Avalon, so we're gonna go with Evo X. And you can see the button is yellow, which means it's ready to be configured. So we're gonna go build, upload image, and we're gonna upload our lipstick. Now we have our lipstick uploaded. Click the button, HD lips, diffuse, copy asset, paste it, and done. That's it. Now we need to test it. So click the button, test, and let's see. And this is our lipstick we just made. Well done, everyone. Of course, you can try some different things with your lipstick. You can add some more shading. You can add some more highlights. You can, for example, smudge the edges. There's tons of things you can do. You can also draw your lipstick by hand. The only limitation is your imagination. So I hope, guys, you liked this video. Hit subscribe if you did, and see you in next tutorial.